Hi, I'm Cliff Sadoff, entomologist at Purdue University, and I'm going to tell you how you can improve your ability to diagnose plant pests by using the Purdue Plant Doctor webpage. Plant problems can make pretty landscapes pretty ugly in a hurry. Early diagnosis can help you correct the problem before it destroys the plants. It is best to take a systematic approach to determine the cause of a problem. The first step is to identify the plant with a problem, and our problem plant happens to be a juniper. There are several applications like Google Lens or iNaturalist that you can use to identify a plant from a photo that you take with your smartphone. The second step is to determine what should not be present on the plant. For example, these junipers have brown needles on their branches. As evergreens, the leaves of junipers should not turn brown, ever. When we look more closely at the branches, we can see brown bags hanging from the leaves. Armed with this information, we can consult available references to find out what caused the problem. We developed the Purdue Plant Doctor webpage to help you diagnose thousands of problems on hundreds of different kinds of plants. This webpage puts all the information that we have on junipers and many other plants at your fingertips. All you need to do is type the first few letters of the name, J-U-N, and select the name from a drop-down list, or if you want to be certain that the plant in front of you is indeed a juniper, you can select the box, evergreen trees, and shrubs, and you can then type J-U-N and compare the photos with the plant in front of you. By clicking on the photo of juniper, you open up to a new screen that has four bars that corresponds to different parts of the plant. Expanding on each one of these bars will give you images of problems that can occur on those plant parts. But since we're interested in problems with the leaves, we look at a gallery of photos on the leaves. And you can expand these images by zooming in so you can get a better view of it. And then once you draw your attention to something that looks like what you're seeing, in our case, the bags of the bagworm look an awful lot like the problem we see in the landscape, you can get information about the problem. When you get to this page about bagworms, the first thing you want to do is to compare the key features, such as cones covered by cut leaf bits, and compare them with these photos to be sure you have a bagworm. Then review the symptoms, the biology, and how to manage this pest. But we have a feature called lookalikes that allows you to compare lookalikes like pine cones so you can be absolutely sure you have bagworms and not pine cones. But since we're really interested in bagworms, you can go back to the bagworm page and find out details about how to manage this pest, starting with removing the overwintering bags that contain the eggs, following up with using different types of pesticides, as well as a list of pesticides that can be used. You can then download this information and save it on your computer, or you can email it or text it to either your clients or to your landscape contractor so that you can communicate how best to manage this pest. If you already know the kind of problem that you have and you just want to look up information about it, you could simply type the name of the problem in the box over here. So, for example, if you are growing roses and you're interested in problems such as black spot, you can look up information about black spot to find out how to manage it. If, for example, it was a hot and dry summer and you're interested in information about drought, you can look at information about drought. Please note that the default condition here will always give you information about trees and shrubs, but if you're interested in how to manage drought on flowers, we have specific information about that particular area as well. Now, in addition to drought, we have information about beneficial insects, whether they be pollinators or they be predators and parasites. And this is quite useful if you encounter these things in your landscape, so you can communicate with your landscaper or your clients to put these guys to use so that your landscapes would become more sustainably managed. So please be sure to visit our Plant Doctor webpage, and don't let your plant problems get you down.